Hello students, in this video we are going to study about multiplication part 2. Okay, in part 1 we already learned multiplication with lattice method. So look at here, this is the lattice method. Okay, so question is, say one student of standard 4 received a scholarship of rupees 315 each. So what was total amount of the scholarship received by the students? Okay, so we can find the total scholarship amount by multiplying 315 by 7. So this is the 7 students. Okay, so 315 by 7, let us multiply using the lattice method, keeping in mind that 315 equals to 300 plus 10 plus 5. So this is the expanded form of 315. So we already know that if we are going to solve the multiplication using lattice method, so we are making an expanded form of this number. So what is the expanded form of 315? So it has the unit place, 10 place and 100 place. So unit place means it is 5, it is 10, 110 means it is 10, and it is 300 means 300. Okay, so 300 plus 10 plus 5. So this is the expanded form of 315, and it has 7. 7 means it's only unit, so we cannot expand in this because 7 is already expanded because it's a unit. Okay, so arrange this like that. So 300 plus 10 plus 5 and multiplying by 7. So 7 threes are 21, and this 20 as it is. 7 tens are 17 and 7 fives are 35. So this is the multiplication of these things. Now let's add this. So it is 2170 plus 35. So total is 2205. So the total scholarship amount received by the student is rupees 2205. Okay, so this is the expanded form. Okay, now look at here. Tai says, Nandu, Tai, last year we learned a different method of multiplying two digit numbers vertically. Can we use the method here? Okay, this is the vertically method. You can solve this multiplication using vertical method also. Okay, generally we are using vertical methods to multiplying or adding or subtracting. Okay, so this is lattice method and this is vertical method. Okay, solve this example using vertical method. Okay, so question is, multiply the following numbers. So look at here, it has given three numbers multiplying by 5. So 5 threes are 15. So we can writing here only 5. 5 threes are 15. We can writing only 5. 1 carry forward here. Okay, apni tha 1 carry forward again. 5 fours are 20. 20 and 1, it is 21. So again we are writing here only 1 and 2 carry forward here. Okay. Now 5 sevens are 35. 35 and 2, 37. Okay. This is the answer. Okay, we already know how to solve this multiplication using carry forward. So 3 5s are 15. So 15 is upon unit place it here, and j tens place with the tens plus upon carry forward here. 3 5 4s are 20. 20 is upon unit place it here, and j tens place with the tens place it carry forward here. So 21 are unit place it here, and 2 it. So 5 7s are 35. 35 plus 2, so it's the last is the sum of number nahi tha, but direct as it is the leun taklo. Okay, this is the answer. Now let's solve this example. 4 9s are 36. 4 9s are 36. So we are writing here 6 and 4 carry forward. This is 404. So it has only 4, so we are writing here 4 as it is. Okay, now 4 4s are 16, so it is 16. Okay, now next is 9 fours are, again it is 36. So we are writing only here 6. 3 carry forward here. Sorry. It has 3 carry forward, not 4. Sorry for that. Because 4 nines are 36, 6 here and 3 carry forward here. So it remains 3. Okay. It remains 3 and 4 fours are 16. Okay. Now 9 fours are 36. So we are writing here 6. 3 carry forward here. Okay. 9 fives are 45. 45 and 3, 48. So we are writing here 8 and 4 carry forward. 9 threes are 27. 27 and 4 it is 31. Okay. This is the answer. Hope you understand how to solve these types of multiplications. Okay, students. Now we will stop here. Thank you.